Vice President Yemi Osinbajo has declared his readiness to waive his constitutional immunity to enable the most robust adjudication of several baseless allegations, insinuations and falsehood against his person and office. Professor Osinbajo made this declaration in a tweet he personally authored this afternoon, yesterday afternoon. Osinbajo tweeted, "In the past few days, a spate of reckless and malicious falsehoods have been peddled in the media against him by a group of malicious individuals. The defamatory and misleading assertions invented by this clique had mostly been making the social media rounds anonymously. The Vice President has instructed the commencement of legal action against two individuals, one Timmy Frank and another Catch Ononuju, who have put their names to these odious falsehoods." Osinbajo vowed to waive his constitutional immunity to enable the most robust adjudication of these claims of libel and malicious falsehood. Now, earlier on, Plus TV Africa spoke with a legal practitioner, Christian Wogo, on this matter. Vanguard newspaper has apologized to Vice President Yemi Osinbajo over a report the latter said is injurious to his person. In a statement published on its website on Wednesday, the newspaper also said it is retracting the entire report. In the story titled 90 billion naira FIRS election fund, Osinbajo's problem, not 2023 politics, Frank, Vanguard had quoted Timmy Frank, a former deputy national publicity secretary of the All Progressive Congress, who accused Osinbajo of mismanaging some funds. Frank was quoted as saying Osinbajo's recent experiences has nothing to do with 2023, but alleged mismanagement of about 90 billion naira released by the Federal Inland Revenue Service to prosecute the last general elections in favor of the APC. Eze Anaba, Vanguard editor, said in the statement that the newspaper has discovered the story lacks factual substance. Osinbajo had, through his lawyers, threatened to sue the newspaper if it did not apologize and retract the story.